Right, so this is the research instrument development, the course of one of the course that you have already registered in the department. So with me again, welcome to my course today. Let's see the slide. This is the instrumentation and then the sampling techniques, the research conclusion and research validity. To come to the validity of the research, so when you come to the conclusion that would be the final product of your research, you have to ask a question like how valid is my conclusion, how strong is my conclusion, how good is my conclusion. It all depends very much on the instrumentation or the sampling techniques. So how would you or how did you take your sample will influence the strength of your conclusion, and how well you set up your instrument also influences the research conclusion. So that's why instrumentation is very important. So in an instrument knowledge or instrument development, we have to ask a question like, what is an instrument? Instrument is the tools, right? The instrumentation is the procedure. So when you do the, you are collecting the data, you use the tool called instrument. When you administer the instrument to collect your data or to gather your data, it means that you are going to the so-called the process of instrumentation. Making instrument is instrumentation. So from making instrument until you administer the test, for instance, or distributing the questionnaire, for example, those are all instrumentation. Some questions arise when you go to the field and you hold in your hand instrument, for example, where will the data be collected. So talking about the situation or talking about the the place you are in collecting data, and then when is the time, and then how and who. All questions are very important to ask, because in administering the data collection, you have to see these kinds of things as factors that will influence the way you collect the data or the way you use your instrument. In a qualitative research, instrument is the researcher himself or herself. But in a quantitative research, instrument should be developed, right? So the course of instrument development or research instrument development in this case is more on the quantitative research. Later I will give you some maybe at glance things about a researcher in a qualitative research as a key instrument, but I will give you more thing about instrument in a quantitative research. Let's go to the first, adopting the instruments. So sometimes a researcher may totally take the other researcher's instrument as her or his instrument. So when you need, when you don't have time to set up your instrument because it needs more time, long time, so you may go to or you may read or find articles in a reputable journals, or you may read the books, or you may read the research report from other students or alumni. In this case, you can take her or his instrument as adopted instrument, right? So you can use the instrument if the instrument has the same characteristic with yours or your topic. For example, you take the anxiety instrument of anxiety questionnaire, for example. You may take someone else's instrument from the journal articles or from the research report like dissertation or thesis or scripti. You may also use authorized instrument from the authorized institution of test makers like TOEFL test or IELTS or TOEIC and so on. So may if it is in line with your context, then it is okay. The next one is sometimes a researcher may partly take some researcher's instrument or other researcher's instrument. Partly take means you can take some of the aspects or some of the items of the instrument you see in other articles or in the books or research report. So you adapt. This is called adapting. You adapt by changing some aspects, for instance, giving or adding more indicators, or you can leave some aspects or indicators, or you leave some items from the instrument you take. Then you use the instrument after you revise the instrument, after you change anything about the instrument you don't need. In this case, you can use that instrument. The question is it a need to have a validity process or to make a process of validating such instrument? Yes, I think you need to make sure that the instrument you change after you adapt is good instrument, or it will require good characteristic good requirement of the better instrument in this case. You may also use take some parts of the authorized instrument. Authorized instrument means earlier that you can have TOEFL, for example, or IELTS, but in this case you just take a reading part of the TOEFL test, for example, or a speaking part of the IELTS test, and then you take it for your instrument. Of course, you have to make validation before you go to the field and use your instrument in reality. And then the last one is making the instruments by yourself. If you have a long time and you are sure that the context or the topic you do in your research is very complex and very specific, then you have to make the instrument by yourself in this case. Or you don't have time to see, or you try to find the similar instrument but you cannot find, then you have to use your own. In this case, when you use your own, you may need a long process, right? So from identifying the construct, try to read more books about the construct of the instrument, and then finally you have to to make sure that the instrument is effective to use, and validating, making indicators are things that you have to make sure you find it in your instrument. So usually if the researcher takes the instrument or makes the instrument by himself or herself, it means that it is your own instrument. Other people may cite your instrument, and then you will be popular, for example, after the instrument you make as more citation. Okay, everyone, any question? This is the introduction of developing instrument in a quantitative research. Do you have any questions?
May I ask?
Okay, who's speaking? Mention
Prima
your.
Diva.
Okay, Prima.
I'd like to ask from the type of non-test quantitative research. I'd like to ask if we use different type of tests, will it affect the validity, reliability, and objectivity of the research?